You're asking the wrong minister when you say how long will we do this. Because it is the ministers of Pakistan who will tell you how long Pakistan intends to practice terrorism.
S. Jaishankar's defense of India's decision to buy Russian oil.
S. Jaishankar has held talks with his Russian counterpart Sergei Lavrov in Moscow.
S. Jaishankar is all set to meet U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken.
तुम कौन होते हो मैं कहने वाले? यूरोप खरीद रहा है तेल उनसे. हमारे लोगों की जरूरत है. हम खरीदेंगे.
And why don't they allow Iranian oil to come into the market? Why don't they allow Venezuelan oil to come into the market?
Bhavataha Prativeshinaha Bhavataha Swabhavikaha Shatruhu Prativeshinaha Bhavataha Mitramasti. Your neighbor is your natural enemy, and the neighbor's neighbor is your friend, by Acharya Chanakya. India's foreign policy was originated in the 300 BC. Not only about India, the world, in fact the world, it had looked towards the foreign policy for the first time in the 300 BC. Yes, Acharya Chanakya had shown to the world about philosophy, economics, physics, teaching, etc. and what not. But today, we exhibit Adam Smith as the father of economics. Because we are much more influenced by the Western media and Western nations. As we needed evidence for every goddamn archaeological source that belongs to India. Where can we get the evidences from if the Takshashila University was burned down by the Huns? Where can we get the evidences from if the Nalanda University was burned down by Bhaktiyar Khilji in 1193? Where it took, you know, more than three months to burn down all the books and manuscripts. Today, Bharat runs in the footsteps of Acharya Chanakya. Since the delayed independence up to the 1991 economic reforms, we were not in much touch with the other countries. So, during the 1991 economic reforms, the privatization, industrialization, liberalization, and the globalization had begun. So like after that, you know, even though after like 1995 and 2000, do you know the reason that why the Indian foreign policy is very much recognizable nowadays? What's the reason behind the world pulling up their socks? You see, the Indian foreign policy, it had begun its like taken its pace off like from the 2015-17 onwards, and also during the COVID times, we have in fact helped the whole world, where we have manufactured and exported our vaccines to different parts of the world. We have also brought many Ukrainian students and also other students to India during the Russia's invasion. We have also brought like many innocent Afghani people during the Taliban invasion. See, in front we have three questions. Why India is taking on Europe and other Western nations? And why and how India is maintaining vigilant or delicate relations with China? And the last question, how did India transform from being the covert nation to the most courageous nation in the world? See, India wants to maintain its strong relationship with Europe and other Western nations on mutual respect. Why mutual respect? Because it is one of the features of the Indian foreign policy, where it also includes mutual non-aggression, mutual non-interference in others' internal affairs, and equality and others. But see, since we are willing to respect Europe and other Western nations, do you think that these countries, Western nations, are also willing to respect India? The question is that why are we buying oil from Russia, even though after Russia attacking Ukraine? See, just imagine the situation of Europe if there would be no Nord Stream. Yes, if there would be no Nord Stream. I mean, from where they can get the gas? But they continuously poke us with these questions. See, if you buy oil from Russia, it is perfect. But if we buy oil from Russia, it is imperfect. What the hell is this? Western governmental organizations like USCIRF, United States Commission on International Religious Freedom, they constantly attack our Indian democracy, different Western think tanks, they constantly in fact degrade Indian democracy. While lecturing us, these people also send, like, you know, provide them tons of money to the missionaries, and they send these missionaries to India in order to convert the innocent people, those who are living in India. And these people, they are trying their best to make the Kashmir issue as a bilateral issue. The Western media and Western nations, they kept on commenting that why, like, India is abstaining from the Russia-Ukraine conflict. Before saying anything, can you just look back at your history, that what you have done? What you have done to Afghanistan, even though staying there like more than 20 years, you have left them in a miserable condition where those people, those innocent people, are suffering from those Talibans. And you also, you people kept on commenting like, why is India buying oil from Russia? Here you get the final answer. The reality is, if we wanted to buy oil from Venezuela, you have put sanctions on them. If we wanted to buy oil from Iran, you have also put sanctions on them. Then where do you want us to buy the oil from? And what are you expecting us to pour in our vehicles? Kerosene? Or water? See, this is the conclusion where you would get the answer for the question that why India is taking on Europe and other Western nations. So if you wanted to know about, like, China, and believe me, please trust me, that the next video is gonna be huge. It's gonna be big. Thank you everyone. Jai Hind.
Somewhere Europe has to grow out of the mindset that Europe's problems are the world's problems. But the world's problems are not Europe's problems.